Boston Breeze take that main stage versus the Atlanta FaZe.
Let's go, Boston!
There you hear the chants. Arlington, a big fan of this Boston roster as we are already into P1 here on Bocage. As you saw the graphic listed, one of the more crazier hills on this very map and mode. As Atlanta starting things off well, a nice 9-0 advantage. They wiped the board early, but still Boston lingering as they'll put their first seconds on the board. And Arcity is there for one and there for two.
And so far, the two times that Atlanta FaZe have played this map, they are basically winning both times by a margin of 70 points. So right now, Atlanta FaZe putting a lot of pressure towards this P1 hardpoint.
Oh,
a lot of pressure towards low trenches. As Simps does find four, that's a good way to start for the MVP.
But a Lockett, that's four down. And now, some free time for Breach to get back in this game and try to bring it back to more of a level heading. 30 seconds left.
You see a lot of pressure still from Atlanta FaZe towards the middle of the map. Nero gonna be the last player in a position to cause some havoc. He's able to take down two. His teammate NTJ finds the third. Last player here is gonna be Simp. They take him down, and Boston with a great hold on his P4 hardpoint are able to get right back into this game. Nero on a 6-3 trying to pick up that glide.
How many times, Jay, how many times have we talked about with this guy in Nero, a rookie, obviously, for the Breach as he gets cut down off of that 6-3. We know that
one-on-one versus methods, and even though the spawns are still coming in from Breach towards lower trenches, if you're Atlanta FaZe, you're in a great position to have the rotation for P3 as well.
Yeah, that's the scary part for Breach, is not only do they need to get in the hill, but they also have to be prepared for next. FaZe thinking not just one, but two moves ahead as four will drop, and methods already with a big job to do, sees constant FaZe players running throughout Bocage as they will reach that 150-second mark and now over toward the house. Last time we saw FaZe do a great job at really retaking the spawns. This time, it will be Atlanta once more in the preferred positioning. Breach, they have got to get a break. Jay, this very well could be the hill that determines this very map as Selium sits on five.
Yeah, Boston needs to break matches, but we're back on land. Let me do exactly what I'm supposed to do, as they do have a 50-point lead right now. Boston are in control of this P4 hardpoint, but spawn's still coming in from Atlanta.
TJ in a big spot. He ends up getting taken down. Player five and Cap. Now he's called upon to try to make the plays. Simp goes for two. Selium's able to find the third, and we say goodnight to methods. Watching a very common route. TJ looking both ways, but not looking toward the bottom. Great plays from Simp, laying prone. 8 seconds left before FaZe calls this one their own. As Simp, by the way, sits on 46 and 29. A statement game already from Atlanta. Feels like consolation kills at this point as Breach will break in for a moment. The nade will at least leave the hill vacant. The Breach will walk away with the final seconds, but it's Atlanta on the rotation. They're ready for this next one. Can anybody from Boston get here in time? One more second, and that will be the game. See what Nero can do. We'll see what Breach can do. Atlanta FaZe, considered to be the best search and destroy team in the game, and that will be tested versus this Boston roster, who has called this mode their best at many a time. And right on cue, it's Ibizi with the first blood, doing the thing that we expect him to. TJ on the return. He's also got the bomb on his back, so at the very least, best position that you could possibly be in. Beams methods off the head glitch. A great start. As Boston got somewhat of a crossfire set up, he can meet Nero very quickly. Is he gonna predict it? Looks as if he won't. Nero with the big kill there at the end, as Boston will secure our first. Bomb will get planted. A kill here would mean everything, but Ibizi and Simp right on cue. We say goodnight to methods, and now it's all on to Tej. Wondering what just happened to my teammates, what just happened to this round. 30 seconds, player on the defuse, and he will get met with a variety of different shots. FaZe with the defuse, and FaZe will level the score now at 3. One versus two, great info to start. All on to the 1v1, Simp versus methods, and it could be in just a matter of moments, methods. So careful toward the bottom side of church. Simp sees him, Simp spots him, here he comes, and that will be the 1v2. They're out of Simp. A few extra shots for love, and FaZe once again level the score.
And that's just great work coming from Simp. The guy's been playing S&D ever since he's been wearing diapers. So he and he will be spotted. So this is a tough situation to try to get out of. Selium takes down Nero. So now in a 3v2, bomb is going to be planted towards this speed bomb. TJ and Caps will have to try to go big here.
See what they can do. TJ sits inside a radar. Great information, but can't take it there versus Arcity's. All on to Big Cap. Able to find one. A simple read it. Sides it back on up. A few shots into methods, but a 2 versus 3. Cap trying to join alongside of his teammate as they will group up over at P5. The bomb is down. We'll see what FaZe can do.
Yeah, they have to try to make a play if you're Boston. Time is starting to dwindle. They know that they have the information that this bomb is going to be down towards A. Abizi with great shoulders picks up the information that these players are going to be attacking through the middle of the map. Capsule does pick up bomb, though. He does get out with his life as well, so he should be able to get a free B bomb plant.
I want to say Simp heard it. Simp heard it. He heard the doors open right on the bomb. We go, and Simp's able to grab it. All on to Methods. A one versus two, and really one player just has to escape. FaZe will secure it. About Boston, maybe this team could be more well fit for a map like this. But let's go and toss that conversation aside. Why? Because we're seeing Atlanta FaZe do some Atlanta FaZe type of things, ignoring that A objective and instantly going over toward B. Not just one, but two ticks off the start. It takes Boston a good 15 seconds just to realize what's going on, rotate, and efficiently get over toward the other side of the map. But a great start for FaZe, regardless of getting wiped away from that left with one more push. But take a look at Big Cap. Gonna try to make a splash in toward the flank. He's waiting for that information to be given. He's waiting for this pinch to be established. The information is in, and that's where Big Cap can start to make the biggest of plays. That's gonna be one. He'll also look for the second breach. Look great to secure this. 3 seconds left, but Boston will hold off. What was
FaZe? 25 seconds left. They take control. They're pushed out towards B5. You see a lot of Boston players. This is a huge one-on-one. They have to try to take down Slam because this is their only push. They can get out this B5 hit.
We'll see if they look to go for this, given Limes the importance of that in round five, and they will. Breach are going to decide to push this one out. Arsty's ready in a great position. A 2-for-1 trade favoring the side of Atlanta. Arsty's tries to fire in a few bullets, but he gets picked apart. It's going to leave Simp up for the 1v2. Left in a position to clutch, and Simp will answer.
Who finds that first blood, and Simp finds the second on Tenero. They have full mid-map control.
By the way, Simp is also 22-10. He is having himself a map. The respawns belong to the young GOAT. Four in a row. He continues to apply the pressure inside a church, and as long as he remains here, it's prayers out for the breach. Finally gets taken down. But as we said, all of this pressure just allows for that objective to continue to roll. MC gets picked apart inside the middle, but you just see what that does to the objective. Arsty's nearly there. And one more tick to go. Can Breach have another solid defensive hold? This Cap is called upon again. Takes down two. That'll be a nice little three spree for him. Conscious of where FaZe are going to be spawning at. Going to try to apply some more pressure inside of the flank. Boston now left down to four lives. Atlanta still pressuring, still around his Cap. Runs right past one player. Arsene's aware of his positioning. Cap will go for it. Not able to secure it. The 6 versus 3 is Methods. Takes that one on to Arsene's. Nice little shots coming in from Simp, as now it'll all be on to Nero. 1v6. There he goes. A few extra shots toward his teammates as Boston have made their way inside of the base. And they're sitting firmly on that objective. So as long as they remain here, the clock will be stopped. Arsene's trying to take down Methods, but Methods is able to find both. Great plays coming in from him. That's now going to be two ticks already from the breach. Can they hold this? Can they pull off what looked to be the impossible? Atlanta now with just four lives, 38 seconds, but they're able to clear off the objective 4v6. And it's going to come down to this final push.
30 seconds left. Last push coming in from Boston. You see the two players that are coming off spawn. They're wrapped back towards P5. They just try to play these trades as Atlanta FaZe do not have any more spawns to work with. They take control of top radio. They take control of Pat, but Atlanta FaZe, they just need to shut it down once.
It's a big opening kill. It's a big opening kill. And it's Selium who's able to grab it. Arsenis, meanwhile, hangs out toward the back, applying some pressure, but it's Selium. It's Simp. It's FaZe winning the overall fights. Last player on the point is going to be Nero. He gets taken down as well. And it is Simp leading the way for Atlanta at 42-20, and good night to Boston. A hot 3-0 from the Atlanta FaZe to kick off their major one.